Today I'm going to replace the gasket on the passenger side, and it's leaking oil. So I got a new gasket, and I also got another used. It's called the engine cover here. It's a used. So I'm going to replace it. First thing first, we need to disconnect the power. The power is located in the back, so I need to right here. So to show you where what I'm doing here. Okay, here. This guy, there is a screw there. It's a star. I don't know the size yet, I have to find out. And I need to take that out so that I can remove this intake of the passenger compartment here. And then there is a screw down there so that I can take out this, what they call it? Firewall, because it's in. Those two, there's one back here. Two more and one back there. This guy is handy dandy. I'm trying to take out this guy. And we have to use this way to connect it. And then take it out. It's pretty tough. Okay, don't lose the screw. I always put them organized. Now do the same thing on the other side. More space to work on. I can take this out and move down here so that I can work on here. The thing is, I have to get the space. This guy, which is the electronic engine controller compartment. I need to take this out because everything's connected here. I have to take this out so that I can access here. is the, they call the BMW engine central control system. So all the electronic stuff, computer stuff for the engine is all connected through here. I have to take it out. The reason for that is I have to flip over to that side so that I can access underneath this bunch of cable and access the engine cover. Alright, let's do that. This out. This is the motor to control the valve timing. This for ignition coil, and of course all those grounds. And then the three connectors, 1, 2, 3, and I need to take all that out. And then disconnect this. It's the BMW specific. What they called a vacuum recycle, whatever. Basically the gasoline vacuumed into the cam header and be sucked back into the cylinder. Burn. Alright, let's do that. First let me take out those what they call the ignition coil. This guy, there's two things which is used to fasten the what they call holder. Get the ignition coil. The BMW engine design is so, I would say, not repair friendly. Even changing it. The ignition coil takes so much effort. Now I need to disconnect those cable out of here. Now I just need to, usually I just do this. Out. Third one. This one. Space even tighter. Even get it out is not an easy thing. Gosh. This is so tight. How do you get... Now, this ignition... This, this out. Okay, this valve also goes through here and here. Move it out of the way. Also, I need to take this guy out. Okay. So that can be. Now, one more thing with this guy. This guy and take this off. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 of there. This guy to reach, and this tool is just so amazing. I really cannot reach it. Alright, last piece out. Now I should be able to uncover this thing, but it's very tight. I have to use some kind of screwdriver and pry it out. Moving. Maybe I can pull to a pretty tight. Let me make sure there is nothing connect. Okay. Try more. 开了。Open. Good. 2 I cannot replace, it's really hard. So I have replaced 30 out of 32. And they are located, that thing is located all the way down here. Down here. So it's really tough. You have to take out the spring, take out this lever. It's really, really, really tough. And they're like fog. And the one that I cannot replace is down here because all that stuff is blocking. You can see that this is intake, this is outtake, output. The intake one has the variable timing thing driven by this gear. It's very complicated. And anyway, now I need to put it back. But it's fun to look at this thing. This is an oil dripping line. So the oil actually dripping down here into the gear and suck into the hole here and back into the oil pan. So it's actually, it can be very hot here. And so oil needs to be very good. All right. Now let's look at the replacement. Stupid thing, I didn't put this thing.
Start engine and see how it goes.